to a lady who presented to the author a lock of hair braided with his own, and appointed a night in December to meet him in the garden, by Lord Byron. These locks, which fondly thus entwine, in firmer chains our hearts confine than all the unmeaning protestations which swell with nonsense love orations. Our love is fixed, I think we've proved it, nor time, nor place, nor art have moved it. Then wherefore should we sigh and whine, with groundless jealousy repine, with silly whims and fancies frantic, merely to make our love romantic? Why should you weep like Lydia languish, and fret with self-created anguish, or doom the lover you have chosen on winter nights to sigh half-frozen, in leafless shades to sue for pardon, only because the scene's a garden? For garden seem, by one consent, since Shakespeare set the precedent, since Juliet first declared her passion, to form the place of assignation. Oh, would some modern muse inspire and seat her by a sea-coal fire? Or had the bard at Christmas written and laid the scene of love in Britain? He surely in commiseration had changed the place of declaration. In Italy I've no objection, warm nights are proper for reflection. But here our climate is so rigid that love itself is rather frigid. Think on our chilly situation and curb this rage for imitation. Then let us meet as oft we've done, beneath the influence of the sun. Or if at midnight I must meet you, within your mansion let me greet you. There we can love for hours together, much better in such snowy weather than placed in all the Arcadian groves that ever witnessed rural loves. Then, if my passion fail to please, next night I'll be content to freeze. No more I'll give a loose to laughter, but curse my fate forever after.